Hello, friends. Welcome to the first session of a new lesson, Lesson 27.
Hello, everyone. Here we are again with another part of TV English.
朋友们好，今天是第27课的第一讲。在这一讲中，我们要学习课文 Robert Bruce, King of Scotland. 通过这篇课文，我们要了解一下被动语态。这也是我们本课语法学习的重点。好，下面我们就来听一遍这个故事。
Robert Bruce, King of Scotland. Many centuries ago, Scotland was ruled by a king named Robert Bruce. He was a wise king and a brave soldier.When the English army invaded Scotland, Bruce took up arms and led his people in the defence of their country. Battle after battle was fought. 6 times Bruce led his brave little army against the enemy, and 6 times his men were beaten. His army was scattered.And he was forced to go into hiding, in the woods or in lonely places in the mountains. One rainy day, Bruce lay on the ground in a hut, listening to the sound of the rain on the roof. He was tired and sad, and ready to give up all hope. It seemed to him,that it was no use trying to do anything anymore. As he lay thinking, he saw a spider over his head, trying to spin a web. He watched her as she toiled slowly and with great care. 6 times she tried to reach the opposite wall to fix her thread.And 6 times she failed. Poor thing, cried Bruce. You too know what it is to fail. But the spider did not lose hope. With still more care, she tried for the 7th time. Bruce almost forgot his own troubles.As he watched her swing herself out upon the slender line. Would she fail again? No. The thread was carried safely from one wall to the other. I too will try a 7th time, cried Bruce. He got up and called his men together. He told them of his plans.And sent them out with messages of cheer to his disheartened people. Soon there was an army of brave Scotsmen gathered around him. Another battle was fought. This time the Scots won, and the English invaders were driven out of Scotland.
在我们讲课文中的句子之前，先来看一下课文的标题。
Robert Bruce, King of Scotland.
在标题中 ,King of Scotland 是 Robert Bruce 的同位语。课文第一句说，很多世纪以前，苏格兰由一位名叫 Robert Bruce 的国王统治。那么我们来看看原文中的句子。
Many centuries ago,Scotland was ruled by a king named Robert Bruce.
根据前面的介绍，我们知道 many centuries ago 指的是14世纪初叶。Was ruled 是被动语态。A king named Robert Bruce 意思相当于 A king whose name was Robert Bruce. Named 是过去分词，修饰前面的名词King, 过去分词短语做某个名词的后置定语时， 在句法功能上相当于一个定语从句。面临异族的入侵， Robert Bruce 拿起了武器，领导人民奋起反抗侵略者。我们来看看课文中的句子。
Bruce took up arms and led his people in the defense of their country.
在这句中， took up arms 意思是拿起武器， led his people in the defense of their country 意思是领导他的人民保卫他们的国家。领导或者率领某人做某事，在英文中要用lead somebody in 这样的结构来表达， in 后面可以跟名词短语或者动名词短语 doing something。 我们来看一下例句。
For 10 years he led his men in the search for the buried gold。
他带领手下人花了10年时间在寻找埋在地下的金子。
5 years ago, he led a team in climbing the peak of the Himalayas.
5年前，他曾率领一支队伍攀登喜马拉雅山的高峰。课文的第二三段讲 Robert Bruce 率领的苏格兰军因寡不敌众而屡战屡败，军队溃散了， Robert Bruce 本人也被迫躲藏起来。在这种处境中， Bruce 开始变得心灰意冷起来。课文中没有直接的描绘战斗的场面，而只是带了一笔，说战斗打了一场又一场。我们来看看这句的英文。
Battle after battle was fought.
这个短语的意思是一场接一场的战斗。 After 在这里是介词，用于连接并列的两项，表示连续。注意这句中的主语是 battle， 是单数，所以后面被动语态中的助动词也要相应的用第三人称单数形式 was fought 这一被动语态。下面我们再举两个类似 battle after battle 这样短语的例子。
Bus after bus.
一辆接一辆的公共汽车。
Day after day.
日复一日。Bruce 带领他那支勇敢的但人数不多的军队6次抗击敌人，但6次都失败了。我们来看看课文中的这个句子。
6 times Bruce led his brave little army against the enemy, and 6 times his men were beaten.
这是一个并列句。6 times 意思是6次，在句中做平度时间状语。介词 against 在这里表示抵抗。Were beaten 是被动语态，意思是被打败。第二段讲 Robert Bruce 领导的苏格兰军队在战斗中连连失利，这一段中一连出现了好几个被动语态的结构。我们来看一下。
Were beaten
被打败。
Was scattered
被击溃。
Was forced to go into hiding
被迫躲藏起来。在概要的叙述了总的战争形势后，叙述开始集中到故事的主人公 Robert Bruce 身上。下面一个句子为我们描绘了一幅生动的画面。
One rainy day, Bruce lay on the ground in a hut, listening to the sound of the rain on the roof.
一个下雨天， Bruce 躺在一间茅屋的地上，听着雨点打在屋顶上的声音。 One rainy day 是时间状语，注意这里的时间状语前面不加介词， Listening 是现在分词，表示伴随状况。整个现在分词短语呢，在句中做状语。刚才的句子中，细节描绘充分，画面感很强，营造出了一种凄凉的氛围。这种氛围很好的烘托了 Robert Bruce 此时此刻的心境。
It seemed to him that it was no use trying to do anything anymore.
在他看来，再做任何努力都显得徒劳无用了。It seemed 后面跟一个 that 引导的从句，这是一个句型，意思是看起来怎么样。在 it seemed 和 that 之间也可以加一个介词短语 to somebody， 比如这句中 it seemed to him that， 意思就是在他看来或者他觉得怎么样。在 that 从句中还有一个惯用句型 it was no use 加动名词短语，也就是 doing something， 意思是做什么事情没用。这个句型是一个否定结构，所以 anything 不能用 everything 替代。 anymore 是一个习用短语，意思是再怎么样，它一般只用于否定结构。下面呢，我们就刚才句子中的语言点提供一些用法例句。我们先来看看两个句型的。
It seems that he won't come.
看起来他不会来了。在口语中 ，it seems 后面的 that 可以省略。
It seemed to me that everything was turning against me.
看起来似乎什么事情都跟我作对。
It's no use crying over spilt milk.
这句话直译是牛奶已经泼出来，哭也没用。根据它的意思，可以翻译成相应的汉语，意思是覆水难收。下面我们再来看看短语 anymore 的用法，注意它用于否定结构中。
Let's not quarrel anymore.
我们别再吵了。
I don't want to see him anymore.
我不想再见到他了。英语中有句谚语 ，Every cloud has a silver lining. Every cloud has a silver lining.意思相当于我们汉语的天无绝人之路。那么是什么使 Bruce 得以绝路逢生呢？我们来看看一个句子。
As he lay thinking, he saw a spider over his head, trying to spin a web.
他正躺在地上想着，忽然看见头的上方有一只蜘蛛在织网。As he lay thinking,是时间状语从句 ，as 表示当什么时候 ，thinking 是现在分词，做伴随状语，修饰动词 lay，trying to spin the web 也是现在分词短语，做主句的宾语 ，a spider 的补语。现在分词短语做宾语补语的时候，宾语前面的动词一般是。表示感觉或心理状态的动词，我们来看几个例句。
I heard someone knocking at the door.
我听见有人在敲门。
Did you feel the house shaking?
你感觉到屋子在震动吗？ As we go on with the text, we'll find that the pronoun she.Is used to refer to the spider. 下面我们会发现，在课文中用了人称代词 she 来指代 the spider. 英语中除了用 it 来指代动物以外，有时候也可以用人称代词来指代动物，比如用 he 来指代 a dog 一条狗， 用 she 来指代 a cat 一只猫。至于是用 he 还是用 she 来指代某种动物，一般来说是一种习惯用法，并不一定说明被指代的动物是雄性还是雌性。 OK, let's see what Bruce said when he saw the spider fail to fix her thread again and again.
You too know what it is to fail.
这句话可谓是触景生情了，意思是你也知道失败是什么滋味。 What 引导的名词性从句做 know 的宾语，不定式 to fail 是从句中的事实主语。我们可以把 it 看作是代表这个不定式，充当从句中的形式主语。看到那只蜘蛛也是六次努力六次失败时， Bruce 颇有点同病相怜的感慨，但是见到蜘蛛在做第七次顽强努力的时候， Bruce 心情开始有了转变。
Bruce almost forgot his own troubles as he watched her swing herself out upon the slender line.
当他看见蜘蛛在纤细的蛛丝上摆动的时候，Bruce 几乎忘掉了自己的烦恼。 As 后面连接的是一个时间状语从句，请大家注意 watched her 后面的 swing 是不带 to 的动词不定式。观看某人做某事在英语中的表达是 watch somebody do something， 这种用法我们以前已经提到过。关于这一点呢，大家还可以参阅书上课文注释第五条。 Swing herself 后面的 out 是副词，表示离开原来的位置。 Line 在这里和 thread 的意思相同，表示蛛丝。这一段讲 Bruce 在蜘蛛织网这件事上大受启发，重新振作起来，领导他的人民再次抗击英格兰入侵者，并且大获全胜，把英格兰军队赶出了苏格兰。这段第二句 called his men together 意思是把他的手下人召集起来。好，我们再看看这段中的另外一个句子。
Soon there was an army of brave Scotsmen gathered around him.
不久在他周围聚集起一支勇敢的苏格兰军队。这句中的 gathered 是过去分词， gathered around him 这个过去分词短语的意思是被聚集到他身边，它相当于一个定语从句 which was gathered around him， 修饰 an army。 OK, that's all for the explanation of the text。 好，课文的学习就到这儿。最后我们为大家念一首小诗， The Coming of Spring。
The Coming of Spring. I am coming, little maiden, with the pleasant sunshine laden, with the honey for the bee, with the blossom for the tree. Every little stream is brightAll the orchard trees are white, and each small and waving shoot has for thee sweet flowers or fruit.
这首诗有两节 two stanzas， 每四行为一节，每两行押尾韵。诗中的 I 是指春天，这里呢用了拟人化的手法。这首小诗节奏非常欢快，表现了春天到来时大自然的勃勃生机。好，今天这一讲我们就到这儿，请朋友们在课后阅读一下书上的被动语态部分，下一讲我们要做专门的讲解。 Well, that's it for today. Join us next time.
Goodbye for now. See you soon.